Hi, Sam Bell here for Guitar Interactive magazine, and today I have the pleasure of introducing one of my pedals, which is the JHS and Boss collaboration of the Angry Driver. Now, a bit of history about this pedal. Obviously, Boss have been around for many years and they're probably one of the biggest pedal companies in the world, and rightly so. Their pedals are classic and innovative, and they've lasted throughout the years. And one of the most popular of the overdrives that Boss actually have and still sell to this day is the Boss Blues Driver. Some may recognize it as an overdrive pedal with a blue casing and just three volume, tone, and gain controls. Now, the other side, another pedal which is going to be talked about today, is a pedal from the company JHS, who are a relatively new company. I say relative, they've been around for a while, but they're doing some fantastic stuff. Very boutique style pedals, high quality stuff. And they have a YouTube channel, and the guy who runs JHS pedals is a big fan of Boss. Now, he has a pedal with JHS called the Angry Charlie pedal, which is kind of a hot rodded Marshall JCM 800 vibe. And somebody we might all well know and love, Andy Timmons, is quite well known for using a combination of both the Boss Blues Driver and the JHS Angry Charlie, often using the Boss Blues Driver for crunchy clean tones, and of course the Angry Charlie for aggressive, more high gain lead tones, and combining them both as well. And that is exactly what this Angry Driver pedal does, the JB-2. So this basically is two pedals in one. You've got the JHS Angry Charlie and the Boss Blues Driver, and you have different options of switching between different combinations. Now, we're going to go into that, but just to break down the two vibes of the sound. So here at the moment, the pedal is in Angry Charlie mode, which means we have a red light, and the top controls of these, we've got the level, tone, and drive. So we've got everything set around noon, and we get this kind of sound. I'll just play some open power chords. So as we can hear, it's a very mid-range, like lower mid-range, bottom mid, tight, low-end drive. It's very high gain as well. And just to let you guys know as well, this is all going into a clean channel of a TH30 orange head, which is going into some vintage 30s, and it's just an SM57 on the grill there to get the tone. So it's just straight into a clean amp. That's the amps we're using. So that's the tone, and that's everything pretty much midway. Now, actually, one thing I love about the Angry Charlie drive is if I go to the neck pickup on a single coil and roll the volume back, It cleans up really nicely, and that's with the gain halfway. So obviously I'll demonstrate some of the EQ and drive settings for both of these in a minute. But let's have a look at the blues driver. So when we turn the far right-hand control to blues driver mode, this simply makes a cool blue light appear. And in these first two modes, just worth saying that simply by selecting each of those modes, it is a simple on and off pedal. It's like having one of those pedals on the board. And there's some multiple switching options that we'll have a look at later on, but which is pretty cool. So let's have a look at the tone of the blue channel, or the blues driver. So similar settings. So that gives us a bit more of a crunchier tone. I'd say there's a bit more detail in the upper mid-range there, just to give us more of that bluesy twang vibe. Now, the actual blues driver pedal doesn't quite have that amount of overdrive, so this pedal gives us the benefit of having a little bit more of that sound. So, that being said, where some of the magic really happens with this pedal is when we start going into the other modes. So often people like to boost or stack their overdrive pedals. Sometimes they have a lower gain pedal pushing into a higher gain pedal to make the lower mid sort of tighten up, and it gives you that preamp feel when you're doing the lead stuff, a bit more sustain and compression. And sometimes you can do the reverse as well if you want to on this. And you can also run parallel, so you can have both overdrives working simultaneously, not pushing each other, but just to really be able to dive into the EQ. So I'm going to just demonstrate the probably the most common setting, actually, is the blues driver going into the JHS drive, and then the light becomes this cool pink color. So this is what it would sound like with those two things. So this is the blues driver pushing the JHS Angry Charlie. So the next available mode on this pedal is having either the blues driver or the Angry Charlie as a switchable in between them both. Now, this is something I personally use. I often do lots of gigs where you end up just borrowing backline and having a clean amp. And I like to use the blues driver as a crunchy clean and then just step on that to have my lead or higher gain sound, which is very useful. So that's just like having the foot stomp action there, just to switch between. You can also use a remote foot switch on this setting in order to turn off the actual pedal itself, so you can turn it on and then be able to switch between those two, but obviously this pedal comes as itself like this. So one of the most coolest things I think about this pedal is being able to combine the drives in different ways. You've got series and parallel. Series meaning one pedal going into the other, and parallel meaning both pedals running simultaneously and not affecting each other, but getting the overall sound out of both of them. So you've got the JHS into the blues driver mode, or the blues driver into the JHS mode. So I'm going to go to the blues driver into the JHS mode, and I'm going to get what I'd call a sort of typical setup that you'd have if you wanted to push an overdrive sound for a modern high gain sound. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn up the level on the blues driver a little bit, and then turn the drive down on the blues driver and the tone down on the Angry Charlie, and I'm going to boost the tone a bit on the blues driver to get more of that mid-range in there, and then let's see how that sounds. So it's pretty ferocious, there's more gain than you can shake a stick at, but actually still, if I roll the volume back, I still retain some of that mid-range and classicness from the blues driver as well. Something I really like to do as well in my own sound. And I think part of the appeal of this pedal is having that available in one stomp. Now, if you put the remote foot switch in on this mode, then it will bypass the blues driver going in, so you could use it as a kind of boost with your Angry Charlie sound as the main switch, if that makes sense. Highly recommend checking this out. So let me just do some more playing there with this sound, just to demonstrate it. So plenty of gain there to play with. Feels fantastic. Let's have a look at the parallel mode. So this is where we can actually get a bit, it's not for the sort of gain stages here, we can really sort of combine the EQ of each pedal. So let me just experiment here. If I bring the gain down actually on these both, I'm gonna bring them back to around about 11 o'clock. And I'm gonna, now I can sort of use these at the level controls as a kind of blend between. So let's just go up to about midway and have this. So this is our bass sound. If I wanted a bit more of the Angry Charlie bite and sort of lower mid-range, I could turn the tone up in here. Or maybe I want that extra bite, but want to turn down the Angry Charlie so it's a little bit more within behind the blues driver. So now we're getting some nice lower gain tones. So you get a bit of clarity there. Let's put a bit more mid-range on that blues driver. We're just experimenting. There's no right or wrong sounds, but just to give an idea that you can really use this as a kind of mixing bowl of overdrive. Maybe if I turn up the, let's get a bit more angry driver in there and a bit less of the blues driver. We get this kind of sound. So now the mid-range has really changed. It's become a lot more honky. So a whole host of options. Let's just go back to the initial sounds just to give a bit more perspective here as well about the versatility of each of these. I'm gonna go back to the, and in fact, just to get us in the ear of the EQ that they both offer, let's just, I'll play an A open note on the Angry Charlie. When you turn the tone up, you do get a little bit more of that fizz at the top end, and if you get it all, if you turn it off, you get this really dark, almost sort of fusion-y. Kind of tone, which is really nice to play with. If you turn up the tone a little bit and turn the volume, the gain back on the Angry Charlie, we're getting into that kind of bluesy territory again, maybe a bit more mid-range. So as you see, it rolls back a lot, and even by itself, if we turn the gain all the way up now. So more gain than you can shake a stick at just by itself, which is nice if you don't want that super preampy feel, you just want that kind of nice fuzzy, super high gain feel under the fingers, if that makes sense. Those that know will know, and those that don't know should try it because it's a great feeling. Going back to the Boss one again, I think I can find it hard to see here because obviously the white markers at the top here are on the opposite side of the pedal for me. Okay, let's go back to the drive set. Let's see how gainy we can get this blues driver to go, just to show how it's a lot different than the original pedal version of it. Oh, I've got the level just about there. So yeah, this obviously this pedal sound, it's got tons of gain there already. I personally like it at sort of more subdued levels because that for me gives me the character that I know and love about the blues driver, and combining that with the JHS personally is my favorite thing to do. But hey, this is a great melting pot. Cool. So just a note here that I can also play in more keys than E minor. It's just a good key to play in, especially with this kind of pedal. So that is the Boss JB-2, the awesome collaboration of JHS pedals. I'm hoping it'll be around forever, but if you like the sound of this, or even feel a little bit of a tinge just to go and try out, do, because it is a unique pedal and a great collaboration between two fantastic companies, and showing how companies can get on and do great things together if we're all open-minded. So there we are. I've been Sam Bell here at Guitar Interactive Magazine, and we'll see you soon. Thank you for checking out this video. We really hope you enjoyed it. If you want to see more cool quality content from Guitar Interactive Magazine, then please subscribe and hit the notification bell below. We've got tons of lessons, interviews, gear reviews, and many other features to come. Check out these videos here as well. We look forward to seeing you soon.